Thank you, Greg, and good morning, everybody. With my presentation, I will start to give you a brief overview of what the project is about, and I will describe briefly the context of the project, and also very briefly the main output that will be described more in detail later on. Ecope Palumbo project has been financed under the environmental priority of the Central Europe project. The project started in September 2012 and it's finishing at the end of this month. Of course, we have different tasks in the project, but what is the real mission of this project is to contribute to the improvement of the quality of paper for recycling in this area. Okay, if you look at this map, you can see the map of Europe and you see the white area that point out the area where the activity of the project was carried out. You see also the stars. The stars are the sign, the indication of the project partner. Project partnership that was really spread in this area. You see that we have three partners from Italy, three partners from Germany. Most of them are located in these two countries, but then we have also Slovenia, Hungary and Poland, so we have quite a good coverage of the entire area. Most of the partnership is from a university and a research center, but we have also consortium dealing with paper recovery, like Comieco, and we have a public authority from the Lombardia region, and also a packaging research center here in Poland. Okay, let's have a look at why it is important this area for the paper collection. If you look at this data, you can see that the total amount of paper collected in this area is approximately 16 million of tons, which accounts for approximately one third of the recovered paper that is used in the European paper industry. Of course, you can see that there are significant differences in the paper collected because even though Germany and Italy are covered in this area only partially, because only the northern part of Italy is considered in this area and only one part of Germany. Germany has the highest amount of recovered paper collected, and Italy is in the second place. Nevertheless, you can see that also Poland it's quite significant in this area. There are no doubts then that this amount of recovered paper is relevant in this area. Nevertheless, when we look at the recycling rate in the Central Europe region described by this project, by this program, you can see that there are significant differences in terms of paper recycling rates. They are highly inhomogeneous, ranging from 39% in Poland and 76% in Germany. Of course, you can tell from this picture that some of these paper recycling rates are still quite low in this area, and is definitely one of the areas in Europe where we can still have some room to improve the collection rates. it's important also to have a look at what are some trends in the paper sector. Recycling rates have been constantly increased in the last 20 years, but in the last 5 years they started to level out. Partially one of the problems is the decline in the graphic paper. It's definitely true that the decline in newspaper consumption affects the paper recycling rate, since this type of products is traditionally one of the best recycled paper products. On the other hand, the increase that we have in the tissue and in the packaging share does not fully compensate for the decline of graphic paper, because the tissue is normally not collectible due to hygienic reasons, and also the packaging products are very diversified and they are not normally so easy to recycle as many graphic products. Nevertheless, we can definitely state that the major potential that we have in order to increase the recycling rates are especially in those countries, like in Poland, where we see that the recycling rates are presently still far below the average of the European Union. No matter the recycling rates, what is getting more and more important is the quality of paper for recycling, because we can definitely see that improper collection system can drastically reduce the amount of the paper that is available for recycling, and some of the actions that are definitely needed part of the communication that we have in this project is that we need to avoid, or at least to counteract, the increased trends of commingled collection with other materials in some of the countries. We need to promote the use of European standards that are available, like the EN643 standard. And we needed to promote the quality assessment of the collected paper for recycling. We have also to be aware of the fact that improper design can definitely create a problem in the recycling process, lowering the paper quality and worsen, on the other hand, also the environmental impact. In this field, we believe that there is definitely the need of a more scientific approach to assess the recyclability of paper-based products, and we need probably a better definition of what is recycling. Another issue is that paper for recycling is not recycled only in the country where it is produced. Although proximity recycling is something that we see as a good opportunity, we know that this material travels around Europe, and therefore some of the concepts like recycling-focused product design and efficient paper collection must be developed at the transnational level to increase the sustainability of the overall paper loop, because obviously we cannot apply this concept only in some countries and not in the other. A further problem that we have in the paper chain is that it's clear that we have some conflicts. Stakeholders in the paper chain are or can be interested in different things. They have different priorities. Of course, the paper means they have the priority of improving the quality of paper for recycling, but on the other hand, when it comes to the downstream industry, we have the converters that are mostly interested in the quality of the products. And along the chain, then we have other priority, like for the municipality, which is the main priority, is normally the quantity, and the waste management companies that are definitely interested in the profitability of the system. No matter the priorities within the paper value chain, we believe that in order to maintain the sustainability of the paper loop, we need to communicate among the stakeholders. And this was actually one of the tasks within the Eco Paper Loop project, to improve the communication about among the different stakeholders of the paper value chain. The project is structured in four different technical work packages, one dealing with the recyclability assessment, another one on collection system, sustainability assessment, and policy development. All these technical work packages are built around a communication platform, because as I said, in this project, the communication is a very important aspect, because it's not only that we have to develop new tools, it's also that we have to communicate and to promote the discussion among the stakeholders. We had several targets in the project. Now we can say that we have that we are at the end of the project, that we have probably reached most of them, and it's my intention just to describe very briefly some of the achievements that were done in this project. Well, first of all, we have developed a new laboratory assessment method for paper-based packaging products. This new laboratory method is now available, it's published, and the capacity and the knowledge to perform it is available in four different laboratories of this region. One in Germany, one in Italy, one in Slovenia, and the other one in Hungary. Of course, there were already some other methods, but we do believe that this method is a step forward with respect to the possibility to assess the recyclability in a meaningful way, much closer to the industrial standard, and we do hope that this will be implemented along the value chain. We have then used this method to create a large database for paper-based products recyclability, mostly in the packaging sector, but during the project time we also enlarge some of the pre-existing database from INGEDE. So we work with the database that is now available, it's definitely larger than the one that was available before the Eco Paper Loop project. Besides, we have also worked at the development of a scorecard proposal for paper-based packaging products. This scorecard proposal has been presented in a public consultation. We organized this public consultation along with the SEPI. And then it was presented also in an ERPC meeting. Presently, the scorecard proposal has not been adopted yet by ERPC, but there is a deep discussion regarding the thresholds and what needs to be done before to be implemented. But the fact that we were able to develop this scorecard, it's in our mind a big target that we were able to achieve, because this will be the base for the discussion in the next future. Regarding the sustainability aspects, we have carried out some pilot life cycle assessment studies looking at the impact of different product design on environmental parameters. You will hear more in detail what we have done at least for two of these studies. And as a consequence of these studies, we have also, or I would better to say that we are in the process of developing, because we'll be hopefully finished by the end of December, a web-based sustainability recycling calculator. What is that? It is a tool that will allow to translate the results of the recyclability test into environmental parameters. You will see in the next presentation at least the basic structure of this tool that will be at the end of the project available on the EcoPay Group website with a link to a specific to this specific tool. Regarding the collection system, we have performed a deep analysis of what is the current situation in the Central Europe countries, and we developed some recommendation guidelines and also a decision tree that is in process of being developing to help the stakeholder to make a decision how to really improve the recycling rates, but also the quality of their collection systems. Then, with respect to the regulatory framework, we have done a deep analysis also about the current situation in the five Central Europe countries that were addressed by our project, and we have produced a roadmap document, which is basically a project position paper based on some policy recommendation that can be used to further develop a translational strategy in Central Europe. Last but not least, the communication aspect of the project. As you can see here, the project was present in many different conferences, not only conferences of the paper industry, but also several exhibition of conferences dealing with packaging. I would like to mention the National Conference of the Paper Industry this year in Italy, where we had a specific EcoPaper Loop session. We also presented at the PTS Symposium on Innovative Packaging in Munich. We presented in Slovenia at the Impact Fair, and many other, as you can see, during the project life time. The communication was not only at the conference levels, but we participated in a lot of technical committee of the paper value chain, and it's probably worth it to mention that we participated a lot, especially in the European Recovered Paper Council. You can see that we had at least four meetings where the EcoPaper Loop was in the agenda. This was particularly important for us because we wanted to promote the possibility that some of the tools that we have developed will be adopted by the European Paper Recovery Council in the next future, thus ensuring the sustainability of the project after the end of it. Besides, what is also important is that we worked also at the national level. We had at least one seminar in each countries of the project. These national seminars were particularly important because were intended to address specifically the national stakeholders. So we had either a translation from English into the local language or directly in the local language. And as you can see here, this is the second time that we are in Poland during this project. And the first time was 1 year ago in Warsaw, and now we have this final event here in Krakow. And getting back to the reason why we have been two times in Poland is also because we know that in Poland that there is room to improve the paper collection. We know that it's important to promote this discussion in Poland, and we do hope that the Eco Paper Loop project will be one of the instruments that will drive the increase of the recovered paper in this country. Okay, I just want to finish thanking not only the project partners but also the supporter and especially those organizations that were deeply involved in the advisory board of external advisory board of the project, specifically SEPI, Asocarta, Intergraph, Ingede, and Austria Papier Recycling, that they all gave really valuable feedback for our final document, especially, and they were really helpful also to promote the discussion within and outside the project partnership. I thank you for the attention, and I'm sure that the next presentation will go much deeper in what are the output, and will give you the possibility to really understand what were the outputs of the project. Thank you again.
Thank you, Rocchino.